Disappearing Acts by Jason O'Hare, art by David Bucks. My apples are missing, cried Philip. It was the day of the camp's annual farewell party and talent show. Philip was making apple pies to share. Other campers would be bringing fresh-made cookies, performing magic, singing, dancing, and even juggling. Parents were invited too. But while Philip was searching the kitchen storage room for a jar of cinnamon, his apples disappeared from the kitchen counter. Philip swung open the door and stepped outside. In the center of camp, a bunch of kids were getting ready for their acts. Maybe one of them had seen the apple thief. His friend Jenny was out of breath. I'm trying to catch my dog, she explained. My mom dropped him off for my animal act, but someone took his leash. The apples for my pies are disappeared too, Philip said. That's weird, said Jenny. Maybe the same person took the leash and the apples. They agreed to keep a lookout, and Philip walked on. He found Annie in front of the lodge, tying a sheet onto a rope. Hey, Annie, have you seen anyone walk by with a bunch of apples? He asked. Annie shook her head. I've been focused on painting a welcome sign for tonight. I wanted to draw it on the sidewalk, but someone took my colored chalk. Luckily, I'd already grabbed this paint in case it rained, and lucky I found this rope to hang the sheet with. Philip was becoming suspicious. Was someone trying to sabotage their day? He spotted Ricky practicing his lasso routine. Hey, Ricky, see anyone walk by with a bunch of apples? Philip asked. No, said Ricky. I've been trying to figure out this rope. It's different from my lasso, but that went missing. Now Philip was sure someone wanted to ruin the festivities. But why? The twins were getting ready for their clown act. Anyone go by with a bunch of apples? Philip asked them. I don't know, said Steve. We were busy putting on our makeup. We made it ourselves. Why weren't they using face paint? Philip wondered. Was it possible? Did someone take your face paint? He asked. Sam nodded. How did you guess that? I think Annie's using your face paint. Someone took her chalk, Philip said. The twins looked at each other sheepishly. Steve pulled a box of chalk from his bag. We found it under the tree, said Sam. We didn't think anyone was using it, said Steve. So we crushed up a couple of pieces and mixed it with water for our makeup. So Annie has your face paint and you have her chalk, said Philip. This was starting to make sense. He led the twins to Annie. My chalk, she cried. And there's our face paint, said Sam. And Ricky must have Jenny's leash, said Philip. But who has Ricky's lasso? You mean this? Asked Annie. Now it was her turn to act sheepish. I needed a way to hang my sign. Philip led everyone to Ricky, and Annie handed over the rope. My lasso, said Ricky. And that's Jenny's leash, said Philip. Jenny, Annie called across the field. We found your leash. Yeah, said Jenny. So, Philip, did you find your apples? At that moment, Jenny's dog, who'd been running wild, trotted up and dropped a tennis ball at Jenny's feet. Jenny laughed. Did you steal that tennis ball? That's when Philip knew. He did steal it, and now I know who has my apples. It could be only one person. As the group walked toward Dave's cabin next to the kitchen, they saw shiny green apples high in the air. I was desperate. Someone took my tennis balls, Dave said. Fortunately, you're a good juggler, Philip laughed. None of them are bruised. I guess we learned a lesson, said Jenny. Don't assume that things are free for the taking. Even if you're a dog, said Annie, smiling. While the rest of the group searched for the other tennis balls, Philip rushed back to the kitchen to finish his pies. He had just enough time to put them into the oven. In fact, when it was time for the party, they were still warm.